Hello and welcome to another brief lecture on Jewish heroes and heroism. This lecture is part of a series used as part of my research to prepare for the Kosher Riverboat Tours cruise of the Seine River planned for 2022. So today, since we are in the month of Kislev, I thought I'd look at one of the battles of the Maccabees, which is especially fascinating. It happens to be a battle that the Maccabees lost, but nevertheless, there's a particular moment of incredible courage that left a lasting imprint, especially in art history, but also in the kind of spirit of the Maccabean Revolution. It's the Battle of Bet Zekharya, which you can see here in this map, is not too far away from Jerusalem, which is just up to the northeast a little bit. It's near the town of Alon Shvut and Kfar Etzion. Now, what exactly happened here? You have a look at the description of the battle. The Maccabees come down from Jerusalem, where they encounter Antiochus's forces commanded by Lysias. Lysias had already learned that the frontal attack is not the best, so he decided to come down south and then advance to Bet Zekharya through Idumea, and there they had a tremendous battle, and the Maccabees actually had to retreat. But what's the specific moment of special heroism? It's associated with Elazar, who is the brother of Yehuda Maccabee. And here, I'm going to read to you from the Book of Maccabees itself. Here it is in my favorite edition of the Apocrypha. Now, Elazar, called Avaran, there's some interesting discussion why he was called that, saw that one of the animals was equipped with royal armor. What are we talking about? The Syrian Greeks used these ferocious elephants in war. They're really amazing, terrifying creatures. What's going on with this particular war elephant? It was taller than all the others, and he, Elazar, supposed that the king was on it. So he gave his life to save his people and to win for himself an everlasting name. He courageously ran into the midst of the phalanx to reach it. He killed men right and left, and they parted before him on both sides. He got under the elephant, stabbed it from beneath, and killed it. But it fell to the ground upon him, and he died. When the Jews saw the royal might and the fierce attack of the forces, they turned away in flight. So this was ultimately a defeat for the Maccabees, a temporary defeat, but nevertheless, Elazar's heroism is one really bright spot in which you can imagine the incredible courage it must have taken to run up to this strange and ferocious-looking beast and to take it down. You know, I think this actually inspired the famous Star Wars scene of taking out those big walking creatures as well. At any rate, let's have a look at this in terms of art history, because what I find especially fascinating about it, this Gustave Doré, I think, is a fairly realistic kind of depiction of the battle. But in the medieval period, most artists, especially in Christian Europe, had never seen an elephant. So it's really interesting to see when they're reading the Apocrypha. You'll recall that the Apocrypha was actually preserved in Christian Bibles, not in the Jewish tradition. So we have the Greek translation of this book that's still widely read in Christian churches. And they're trying to depict this in illuminated manuscripts. So they don't know what an elephant looks like. They say, oh, it's kind of like a big, you know, like horse thing with sort of a long trunk coming out of its nose. So here's an example in which it looks a little bit like a horse with a trumpet, and notice that the scale is way off, like they have no idea how big an actual elephant looks. Here's another example where the artist just gave up and said, oh, it's basically a horse, right? A big horse. Here's another example in which it's kind of like a happy dachshund or something like that. Another version in which the proportions look about right, but again, the scale is totally wrong, and I have to say that of all the depictions of Elazar's death, this one is perhaps the most horrible, because you can just imagine being squashed in that manner. Here's one in which the elephant gets a little bit closer to reality, but the trunk is totally wrong. And here's one which looks a little bit like kind of a saber-toothed tiger with a trunk. Again, the artists are just flailing about trying to figure out how to depict these elephants. This one is great. Looks kind of like a salamander with these bizarre ears. And here is actually my all-time favorite. This one, I think, inspired Dr. Seuss. So all joking aside, the heroism of Elazar is absolutely amazing, and he has, in fact, earned a name for himself for this tremendous act of courage back in the era of the Maccabees. Thank you very much for watching.